Jimmy Sulawski may not have the build of a typical long driver, yet he's earned back-to-back RE/MAX World Long Drive Championship titles. ESPN Sports Science's John Prankus examines Jamie's phenomenal biomechanics.
At 5'11", 168 pounds, Jamie Sulawski is 3 to 8 inches shorter and up to 107 pounds lighter than his competitors in the RE/MAX World Long Drive Championship. But he can still launch drives that have been measured at over 450 yards. His swing is so powerful that his tee shots can even blast through a sheet of 5/8-inch thick plywood. How do you generate so much speed on your club head?
A lot of it's wrist strength, flexibility. And when you're not a big guy, flexibility is kind of my biggest friend in this sport.
Flexibility is one key to torque, the twisting force Jamie generates around his spine. The greater the angular displacement between his shoulders and hips, the X factor, the more torque that's available to generate massive club head speed. Jamie's hips rotate 49 degrees, while his shoulders turn 166 degrees, creating an X factor of 117 degrees. That's 58% more than the average pro. Kinetisense triaxial sensors reveal that his wrists snap at an angular velocity of about 2,100 degrees per second. The speed and strength in Jamie's wrists, a byproduct of years of hockey training, increases the velocity of Jamie's clubhead speed to over 145 miles an hour, about 20 miles an hour faster than some of the longest drivers on the PGA Tour. To put Jamie Sulawski's length off the tee in perspective, the average PGA drive carries about 270 yards in the air. Jamie's drives carry more than a football field farther. For ESPN Sports Science, I'm John Brinkus.
You know, guys, earlier this year, Jamie beat Bubba Watson and Dustin Johnson by more than 50 yards at Kapalua, but Carl Walter, definitely a different opponent.
Jamie likes to hit the ball fairly high and a little bit right to left, and that is not the kind of shot right now that this grid is helping. Anything that's hooking back up into the wind is not going to go as far.
Hello.
From Alberta, he says hello to ball number one. Soaring through the air here in Nevada.
And again, working a ball into the middle and down that left side is not going to be the answer for the biggest shot he can hit.
Like senior champ David Mobley, Jamie uses an Adams Speedline driver, the official driver of the LDA. He uses zero friction tees and champ spikes on his shoes.
Art, how are the conditions down there by the players?
A little bit of a crosswind. And again, Jamie's playing golf, I think, on these first couple shots. He's going to make Walter earn it. I think Jamie's just going to build. There's a huge gust
down
here. There's a huge gust.
Big gust.
This could be big if he launches this. He just saw that.
He can take his time and get the right swing.
Oh, he did see it.
Will this one reach the fence? It's deep.
It's almost coming back in, guys. It's just everywhere here.
It's going to get to 440, just over the 440 marker. To 444, it looks like. Triple fours, perhaps, for Sulawski. We'll say 443 for now. Off to a great start for this past champion. Final ball of the first set.
Oh! He's just hitting it right in the middle of the club face.
Sulawski. The wind has really shifted here.
It's like timing the gusts. When do you want to take it back? You almost start paying too much attention to the wind rather than your golf swing and your plan.
Let's check out Adam's Exmo of the swing, Art.
It's a simple equation for Jamie Sulawski. Wide, narrow, wide. What do we mean by that? Look at the hands at the top. That's a wide angle. Then he'll create one of the most narrow angles you've ever seen, right when the hands get to the right hip, right there. There's the narrow, and now we go wide again. That's the extension. Wide, narrow, wide for huge distance from Jamie Sadlowski.
Here's Carl Walter, his first set of three. The fourth seed, Sadlowski, the fifth seed coming in. Carl Walter definitely has pop.
And Carl also can launch it way up in the air. I think these conditions would favor a Carl Walter who is able to hit the ball much higher than some of these other players.
Walter, the teacher from Pennsylvania, uses a 4.5-degree crank driver with Fuji shaft. He, too, uses champ spikes. All right, did he switch drivers there?
Carl grabbed the club with less loft. His tendency is high right. His big swing fault would be to cross the line at the top of the golf club. Let's see if that happens. And there it is, just slightly across. Then he flipped the hands, and then you're going to get the pull.
So Carl Walter 0 for 3 for the grip. Jamie Sadlowski now is in a strong position, posting 443. His opponent only has 3 golf balls left.
Jamie has gone back to his signature shaft with how it's forged.
Oh, my goodness.
You're right, Andy, that little draw.
Yep, that's going to get knocked down by that left or right breeze a bit. Just shy of 420. Again, his best is 443 so far.
The wind has died just a little bit. I mean, we're talking 2 or 3 miles an hour is all, but he's trying to get some advantage from the wind.
Oh, that is pulverized down the middle. His left hand did come off the club a little bit after impact. Maybe he didn't
a little thin.
Quite square that up. Yep.
Yeah, a little thin. Lower part of the face, but it got a nice roll.
He's going to get about a 419 rollout, but Jamie Sadlowski in a very strong position, 443.
Watch his feet and legs. Really. So much pressure. Left foot comes off the ground.
That swing speed, it has to. If he posted up on that knee, it'd explode. Here comes Carl Walter. The number to beat is 443. Let's face it.
He can do that.
He's got it in him.
Yeah, we look at the flags down here, guys, and I mean, they change, they start, they go right, left to right.
Let's see the path of this ball. 2 left for Carl Walter. Dead straight.
Just the wind roll.
You can hear the wind whistling on the microphone. That's a great rollout. That's going to do it. That's a winner. That's 446 yards. Carl Walter hit the right side of the grid, Andy. That's the hot side. That's where you get the most rollout. And that's what he got. And he stuns Jamie Sadlowski and moves on to the next round to face Joe Miller.
Let's take a look at Walter's reaction to the winning drive.
Come on.
Arts with Jamie Sadlowski.
Jamie, you filled up the set there, 443. Carl's got 2 shots to go. Did you think he had it in him?
I was happy with the 443, but the wind kind of laid down on my last 3 ball set and then kind of picked up again and he nutted one, so not much I can do.
That sums it up.
So Jamie Sadlowski stunned by Carl Walter's 5th golf ball. And Walter will move on and play Joe Miller in his next match. 2 down, 2 move on, and board and
come.
We return. 2011 RE/MAX World Long Drive Championship powered by Dick's Sporting Goods.
Champ Spikes, the official golf spike of the RE/MAX World Long Drive Championship, trusted by the longest hitters on earth.